Hello everyone and welcome to our Tech Tuesday Tutorials number 103. Today we announce Google Meet's rebrand, its integration with Classroom, and we share a must-have Meet extension called Nod Reactions. So, Google Meet. Until last week it was called Hangouts Meet. There's still a Hangout called Hangouts Classic, and that's what people with Gmail use. It's mostly for instant messaging and a minor bit of video calling for small groups, but it doesn't have all the bells and whistles of Meet. There's also a Hangouts chat that has mostly been forgotten about, and it's only within your domain. We're not talking about any of that. We are talking about Meet, which is now called Google Meet, or just Meet. It's the video conferencing tool that everyone is jumping to now that Zoom is struggling with major security issues. Now, I've covered this in the last couple of Tech Tuesdays, so I'm not really going to go over all the basics of this, but there are some updates. One of the big ones is that it now integrates cleanly with Google Classroom. Yes, you can quickly and easily set up a Meet link in your Google Classroom just for your students in that class. Let's take a look. First, you need to go up to your settings within a Google Classroom. This needs to be set per class. Scroll down to where it says General, and you'll see at the bottom here a section called Meet. If you don't see that, it means that your IT department has not turned on Meet for your account or for your group of people. Once they turn it on for you, you'll see this option, and you'll see a thing that says Generate Meet Link. Go ahead and click that. It will generate a custom Meet link that works only with you and your students in that class and is unique to that class. You'll notice it automatically toggles for it to be visible to students, but you can turn that off. What does that look like for students? Well, I can save this and then come in as a student, and you will see the Meet link underneath the title right there. So this is me as a student, and this is what I see. If I were to try to click this link, then I get a notification that the meeting code doesn't work. And that's actually as intended. I can't create this meeting because our organization hasn't enabled Meet. It says that. That's actually not quite the case. What that means is that our IT department has set it to where student accounts cannot create new Meets. They can only join them. So I have to wait for the teacher to get into that. So as the teacher, I can come in here and I can click on this. And it will be taking me to the staging room, and then I can join. Once I join, I get information and I can add people to it, but that's okay. If they're part of my students, I don't need to manually add them. They can then come into this Meet, then it will give them the option to join, and they can join into the Meet as well. Now I'm in here as student and I'm there with the teacher. The teacher can have a lot of control over student accounts. So as the teacher, I can come in here to the students and I can pull this down and I can mute or remove them. If the student's already muted, I cannot unmute them. They have to unmute themselves. But if I did need to get rid of students or remove them because the class is over, I can go through there and manually remove the ones that did not automatically leave the class. One tool that the teacher has at their disposal is to be able to leave the call and come in here and change their settings to turn off the Meet access to students or even reset the code so it's something different. If I reset the code and say it's not visible, I can save that, and the student, if they went back to the old code, would not be able to join the Meet. So this is one way to make sure that the students can't get back into that meeting after the meeting is done. This meeting link can also be copied so that the teacher can put this into an announcement, an email, or into a classwork assignment or anything else. So we could come in here and say we've got an assignment, and it'll be a question and discussion thing. And we can say we are going to talk about chapter one. And in the instructions of everything we may want to say, we also will put the link. Or we can come here and click add and add it as a link there. And again, we copied this link from the settings. Once you post it, it'll go out to all the students. They'll get the link to that particular class video meeting, and they'll be able to join the meeting that way as well. This is a wonderful implementation. It's very easy to do. You can have it up all the time, or you can have it not visible but still usable and post it wherever you need it to go. There are some administrative considerations here. It's important to know that Google Meet can be turned on or off for users in a school system, but it can be open safely for teachers while limiting student creation of meeting rooms. So this next part's mostly for the tech folks out there. Just know that you can use organizational units or even groups to allow or deny access. One of the things I would recommend for students is for them to have recording, streaming, and video calling turned off. This allows them still to join a Meet, with a code, but doesn't allow them to create their own meets or schedule their own meets, doesn't allow them to stream any of them, and specifically does not allow them to record. Just note that you can set that differently for students or staff. I would recommend that staff have the ability to turn on meets and even record them so that they can conduct their remote teaching. If you're interested in this, you may want to talk to your IT folks and see if this is something that they can help you with. Right, let's move on to the extension called Nod Reactions. Nod Reactions is a wonderful little extension for Google Meet, which gives you the ability to raise your hands, provide thumbs up or other kinds of reactions, all within Google Meet. I'll provide the link in the description, or you can just Google search Nod Reactions for Google Meet. Once you get there, just add it to Chrome. Everyone who wants to benefit from this has to install it. That means that the teacher needs to install it and the students need to install it. I'm now in a meet and I'll see the icons at the top up there. I can give thumbs up, well done, question mark, wow, or even a lol. You can also digitally raise your hand, which stays until you click it off. And you can set your settings for particular skin tones or whether or not you want notifications whenever someone raised their hand. This is particularly good for presenters if you've got a lot of people in your session. And if you want to support them, you can toss them a little bit of money so they can buy a cup of coffee. Right, so once you get this in there, you can invite students to do the same. So students who join the meet do not have that unless they install the extension as well. So you would need to give them the link to install the extension, let them install it, and then they would probably need to refresh their page, which would kick them out of the meeting temporarily and pull them back in. So I'll come here and refresh. I'd have to rejoin the meeting. But then once I join the meeting again, this is me as a student, and I can raise my hand. It'll say student raised their hand. And then when I'm looking at it as an instructor, here it is, the student raised their hand. And that's all there is to it. So I hope you all enjoyed this video and I hope you found it useful. And if you did, go ahead and click that like button. Heck, why not support us and click that subscribe button. Click on the bell icon to receive email notifications. Leave a comment or an idea for a Tech Tuesday video below. Share this video with your friends. And we'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.